Thank you, Madam Secretary, and your team for joining us here today. So Act 77 of 2019 made voting more accessible for folks across the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, but it also increased the burden on our county election officials to administer this new law. These election officials worked around the clock to guarantee free and fair elections, often under threats of their own safety. And we saw that continue this year. So my first question is this. What kind of budget investments do you think we need to make in counties to help them administer free and fair elections?
Thank you for that question. And I absolutely agree with you. You know, the counties were really under a lot of pressure to implement, the requirements under Act 77. With the SHORE modernization, the SHORE system will be built for vote by mail. So it will definitely help the counties when it comes to processing mail ballots more efficiently in future elections. And as I mentioned, we are planning on having that online fully early next year for the counties to utilize. But, you know, it's important for counties to have resources to make sure that you know, we have fair and free elections in this country. So that includes not only funding from state organization or state entities, but also from the federal government as well.
Thank you. And do you think that we're currently funding your department at a high enough level? And what about funding to the counties for elections?
I believe that we are currently funding the department at the appropriate level. Everything in our budget request will be sufficient to fund the 2022 election. And I understand counties, carry the burden of administering elections and funding those elections. So to the extent that we can be supportive when it comes to training, right now in our budget request, we are actually requesting additional positions for the Department of State for our elections team. Pennsylvania is actually the fifth largest state. We have close to 9 million registered voters, but we have the smallest election department in the country. So this budget includes additional positions. It's 21 new positions in elections to support the work of the counties to make sure that they have everything that they need to execute free and fair and accessible elections in this Commonwealth.
Thank you for that. So you've got the smallest team in the country working on the fifth largest voter population.
Yes.
That's a challenge.
Yes, it is.
So you mentioned technical assistance for the counties and training. So I heard from one county official in Delaware County that it would be helpful to have standardized training videos so that everybody was proceeding in the same way. Is that something that's currently planned?
Yes, training is something that we are currently engaged in, and I can ask Deputy Secretary Marks to elaborate on our training efforts.
Thank you.
Sure. Thank you, Secretary Chapman. Thank you, Representative Krueger, for your question. Yes, the Secretary mentioned our budget request, this budget request. Of those additional positions, four of those positions will essentially be committed to doing that kind of work, to training, writing training materials, conducting training, whether those be in-person training or remote training. And we've used those tools, frequently, certainly during COVID-19, to do training sessions with counties. We've done nearly 30 training sessions on SHORE modernization or requirements gathering sessions, demos, et cetera. And most of them have been done remotely through Microsoft Teams. So, we're looking at all the tools, but one of the things we need are committed staff. Having such a small election staff that's committed to doing elections full time, creating those training materials, conducting those training sessions takes time. It takes a lot of work in advance, and we're asking people who are doing a lot of other duties. So I think it's important, and it's part of our strategy to modernize election, to have people committed to doing those trainings. I testified before the House State Government Committee last year. And one thing I heard from county election officials who testified is one of the first thing they said, we need training. And so we want to support them adequately. And this budget request, I think, reflects that.
Thank you. And so if we could add the request for standardized training videos to that list as you're developing it, I know that would be helpful in Delaware County. So I know the job of being a poll worker has gotten tough, and there's a lot of folks who have given that up during the course of the pandemic and over the past few elections. Do you think we need to lift the state cap in pay for poll workers so that we've got enough folks to actually execute these elections on Election Day?
Yes, and that's one of the initiatives I mentioned around election reform. It's important, you know, poll workers are really at the front lines of our democracy, and it's important that they're paid sufficiently to execute their duties.
Thank you so much. And again, thanks for everything you're doing to help us execute free and fair elections here in Pennsylvania. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.